steps biology. In the previous video lecture, we have discussed the classification of the simple epithelium. Okay, and today we are going to discuss about the classification of the pseudostratified epithelium and the stratified epithelium. So let's discuss about the pseudostratified epithelium. The pseudostratified epithelium is always columnary structure. That's why pseudostratified columnar epithelium. And it can be ciliated or non-ciliated. Considering the ciliated epithelium, the cilia is present at the apical surface. There is the basement membrane. This is the basement membrane. And the cells are arranged in a single layer. But they appear to be arranged in many layers. Why? Because all cells do not reach the apical surface and the nuclei are not present in the same level. Okay, the nuclei are at different levels. Okay, so this is the basement membrane and this is the cilia. In non-ciliated epithelium, this cilia is absent. Okay, so where this epithelium is found, this pseudostratified columnar epithelium is found, it is found in the airways of the upper respiratory tract, and the main function of this type of epithelium is secretion, and it also helps in movement of mucus through the ciliary action. Okay, now come to the classification of the stratified epithelium. So, considering the structure of the cell or the shape of the cell, it can be of three types. Okay. So, stratified squamous, then stratified cuboidal and stratified columnar. Okay. As the name suggests, squamous. Squamous means what? Layers, the cells are thin or flat. Okay. And stratified means what? The cells are arranged in many layers. So, how the cells will look? This is the basement membrane and the cells are flat. In the actual structure, the cells of this layer can be cuboidal or columnar. Okay, but if we consider the apical cell, apical layer of cell, they are squamous, thin or flat. That's why the name is stratified squamous epithelium. In the deep layers, the cells may be cuboidal or columnar in shape. Okay, and when the surface cells are degenerated, then that is replaced by the basal layer of the cell. Okay. So, this is the stratified squamous epithelium. So, where this epithelium is found? It is found in the surface of the skin and also in the wet surfaces like your mouth, esophagus, then a tongue, then part of pharynx, then part of vagina also. Okay. So, this stratified squamous epithelium, it has two varieties. One first one is keratinized and the other one is non-keratinized. If keratin is present, then it is called keratinized, like the epithelium that is present on the surface of our skin. Okay, but if we consider the other structures like the esophagus, mouth, then tongue, vagina, okay, that epithelium is non-keratinized variety. Okay, now the main function of this stratified squamous epithelium is protection. Remember that. Now come to the stratified cuboidal epithelium. As the name suggests, the upper layer of this epithelium, upper cells are cuboidal in shape, cube cell. Okay, so how the cells will look? All cells have same height and same width. Okay. cells will look like this. Clear? This is the basement membrane. Okay. So where these type of epithelium is found? It is found in the ducts of sweat gland in case of adults, and also it is present in the pancreatic duct. So what will be its main function? Protection. Then limited secretion, like the sweat gland. So sweat gland, sweat is not always secreted, right? So limited secretion and absorption. Clear? Now come to the third one. This is the stratified columnar epithelium. So the cells are what? Columnar in shape. The upper layer is columnar in shape, and the deep layered cells are they can occupy any shape. Okay, that may be squamous or cuboidal. Okay, so this is the basement membrane. Then the cells are columnar. They have more height than the width. Okay. So where these cells are, these type of epithelium are found? These are found in the large secretory ducts of the esophageal gland and some small areas in the anal mucous membrane. Okay, and also found in some part of vagina. Okay, here urethra also. Then the main function of these stratified columnar epithelium is protection and secretion. Okay. Then there is an additional type of epithelium, the fourth type, that is the transitional epithelium. Transitional epithelium. So this type of epithelium is variable in shape. That's why the name is transitional. Transitional means what? Variable. The shape of the cell varies from squamous to cuboidal. Squamous to cuboidal. Okay. So when the shape of the cell is squamous, when the tissue is at what? Stretched condition. Okay. The shape is squamous. The cells get stretched and their shape change. Their shape becomes flat, tile-like. Okay. And when the shape is cuboidal, under relaxed condition or unstretched condition. Okay. It is under stretched condition. Clear? So this type of epithelium is found in case of the urinary bladder and urethra. Okay. Clear? So the main function of this type of epithelium is that it permits distension. So in this video, we have discussed the pseudostratified epithelium, the stratified epithelium and transitional epithelium and their classification. In the previous video, we have discussed the classification of simple epithelium. Okay. So if you are liking my videos, give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon next to the subscribe button so that you can get all the updates from us. If you have any doubt, you can ask me questions through the comment box. Thank you.